Welcome back to Hot Copy. We're talking with DPWH Secretary Rogelio Singson. Sir, lots of questions for you very quickly. Rod Aruta asks, what are the preliminary measures planned by your agency to lessen the incidence of broken sea walls?
Well, in the case of Manila Bay, there is an open portion of the breakwater.
Correct. No? I've seen it.
So Manila Yacht Club has a breakwater, and then for the port, you have also a breakwater.
Yeah. Kaya naisalba siya eh.
Oh, kaya lang, may open portion, and yun ang talagang tinamaan.
Yeah. No?
So now, the seawall of Rojas Boulevard is just sitting on the armor racks.
Okay.
It's not anchored.
Yes. No?
So we're changing the design. We are now going to anchor those the new seawall that we are putting.
So you are not using MMDA Chairman Tolentino's promenade of a double layer seawall suggestion.
We met yesterday, Mayor Lim, myself, and Chairman Tolentino, and sabi namin baka hindi practical yon,
no? Okay.
First of all, pagkamalapit lang din naman yung dalawang kwan, napaka aksayado, and you will not, it's not sure that it can withstand.
Okay.
No? So, unahin ko, sabi kong ganun, let's restore first the wall.
Okay. The wall, and then the breakwater extend.
Well, there are new technologies again.
We're
using technology.
All right.
Yung mga tinatawag lang wave breakers.
Okay.
No? Which are used in other countries. No, they are just floating pontoons. No, na pag ilinatad mo, pag lumakas ang storm surge, it dissipates the energy.
Okay.
Paglabas niya dun sa wave breaker na yun, bula na lang.
Okay. All right. Francis Leo Manalo asks, when did your men learn to Photoshop though your officials into the pictures? Have you heard of this?
Yes, I saw that, and we have already said that this was this one guy who did it. No?
Yeah.
The photographer. But the three men, the three officials were really there.
Yeah, no, I want to tell you that. I'll vouch for it. Because I did that story for TV Patrol and Bandila. I saw those men every day. In fairness, they were there every day working.
Because they were supervising the cleanup and the sandbagging together with MMDA people. No? So, unfortunately, this eager beaver guy started to manipulate the photos of this three officials. Ipinatong sila sa breakwater.
Okay. All right. So you've dealt with that. Okay.
Yeah, we've sanctioned the person.
Oh, you have. All right. Pao Zuniga asks, what is exactly the budget for the repair of the Buendia Bridge in Makati? There are still too many potholes there and some are deep. You have a lot of problems.
I know.
My God.
We have again, no? First of all, after checking the materials, the asphalt material that was delivered did not pass our standards.
Okay.
Pero nailatad na.
No?
Because when it was checked before it was delivered, apparently people accepted it.
Okay. No?
But after na linatad and we started seeing what they call signs of failure, we had it thoroughly checked as to the strength, and we found out na bagsak no, yung quality. So, it's just a matter of time. We're just waiting for good weather. We'll scrape the whole thing and we're asking the contractor to redo it.
Okay, now can you give a clarification that many people, critics have said, the DPWH projects are delayed, which is why we're experiencing so much traffic, because of cancelled contracts?
That's, we have not cancelled contracts. What we've done is make sure that we spend the money correctly.
Okay.
No?
Ang
pinakamadali sa DPWH ay gastusin ng pera.
How many contracts have you canceled?
What we've done, maybe you're referring to the Ondoy and Pepeng contracts that we canceled because they were all negotiated.
Okay.
No? And
pero pag emergency, sir, naman kasi yung madalian, binibid pa ba yun?
Hindi. Or it's an agreed ang problema ganito, no? When we came in July of last year, there were signed contracts na wala pang pondo.
Okay.
So the contracts came ahead. So sabi ko, let's cancel the procurement by negotiated contract and let's give me all the source documents.
Yeah.
Program of works, ang gagamitin, ano detalya. Walang may bigay. Yung pala, yung kontrata, ang naghanda ng program of work, yung kontratista mismo.
Okay. No? Okay.
Saka naman nakakitang ganun. No?
Iba hindi.
Tapos, I confronted the contractors. Sila pa yung pinakiusapan na tanggapin lang yung kontrata. Sabi ko, baliktad na talaga ang mundo natin.
Oh.
Yung contractor pa yung pinapakiusapan.
Okay. Oh my God. All right. Irma Aquino asks, why can't our roads be... Oh gosh, these questions are be free of humps. Dominga Street in Manila, Pasay area has so many humps. But that's not DPWH. Yeah, that's not, what is that, sir?
Well, those are put up by local officials for safety. You know? Okay. Kaya lang kuminsan, sobrang taas, sobrang dami.
You know?
Halos every corner, linalagyan. I guess magreklamo sila sa local official na kayang-kayang tanggalin yan.
But there should be rules on that, no?
Yes, there okay. are. There are.
Okay. No? All right. Aldrin Angelo asks, bakit madaming sirang daan pa rin sa bansa na hindi natututukan ng gusto? Diyos ko, parang masasolusyon
nila. Pasensya na kayo, minana namin. Napakasamang kalidad ng mga kalye.
Oh, lalo no? na daw ang EDSA, sir, oh, yung iba naka-aspalto, yung iba naman semento.
Totoo yan. As I said, no? What I want to do is really get a contractor to do a long-term maintenance on EDSA.
Maintenance, correct.
But nobody wants to take it.
No one? No way, are you serious?
I'm serious.
No.
Eh kasi, unang-una, tinatapos pa nung Manila Water at Maynila yung kanilang mga linya. No?
Maya't maya
pumuputok.
Oo.
No? So, can you imagine if a private contractor took that challenge? Eh, how can he maintain it properly?
Uh-uh.
In other words, rather than have an expressway, government is willing to pay them. Maintain mo on a certain quality service.
Yes.
No?
Okay. All right. Just very quickly from my Twitter, before we go to another quick break. Okay. Buhay, I won't read this now, but Secretary Singson, what are your plans for Rizal with regards to flooding?
Well, we're completing a master plan of the whole Metro Manila, including Laguna Lake. Now, we're integrating the plans for Pampanga and Bulacan.
Yeah. You know?
So now we can, as I said, I'd like to look at it in terms of an integrated water resource management.
Uh-oh.
Let's look at river basins.
Okay.
Hindi lang yung pasundot-sundot ka kung saan-saan na hindi naman buo.
Yeah.
Sira nang sira yung ginagawa mo taon-taon.
But how much money will you need to put up a lot of the water catchment basins that you've mentioned?
Well, for example, the whole Fort Bonifacio is about 240 hectares. We spent about 60 million.
That's not too bad.
That's not bad.
That's not bad.
We're spending much more than that every year.
Yeah, but then again, it's a private company. So best practices kayo in business.
Always every year. How much is the damage we're encountering now? 3 billion? 12 billion na.
Good point. Good point. We'll take another break, sir. DPWH Secretary Rogelio Singson will still answer your questions when Hot Copy returns.